favori gitaristi var. From Susan Banshees, John McKeogh, Johnny Marr of course, Bill Duffy. I can say these words.
It's hard to say this, but the setting of the concert, of course, is very important, and I could easily say the gig at Kalabalık Festival in Sweden, in the middle of the countryside. It was an unforgettable setting, which made it very special.
In Portugal, Entramuralas.
Entramuralas Festival, for sure. The setting was amazing. Well, at the moment we are living out of Turkey. Volkan's been living in Barcelona for the last year, and I recently moved to Athens. And well, we didn't do it for logistic reasons, but we did it for him for private reasons. Of course, he got married there, and he settled, made a new life there, and we moved with my wife. We moved to Athens because we wanted to leave Turkey. Basically, we never liked the situation there. So it's not for a logistic reason, but for an ideological reason. Maybe we left Turkey, but for logistics. No, we can't really choose this. We don't have the luxury to choose where we live. Whatever happens, happens, and we end up in a place. Finally, we are both out of Turkey. It's fine. Yes.
Mehmet Sander, he's a dancer.
Yeah, modern dancing. He's a good one. Artistic.
We don't have so much influence from Turkey, actually. But what can I say? For music. About music, I can say Erkin Koray, the old guy from 70s, psychedelic rock. He's I like.
I mean, there are many good contemporary artists producing modern art, which I can't name now, but there's some of that in Turkey, which appeals to our taste.
I like to listen to this music from many years. Then it's naturally I choose. No choose actually. It's naturally I do this music.
Yes, yes.
It's not a reason.
Yeah, there is no purpose. This is what comes from Volkan, because
in art, we like dark feelings. Maybe this is the reason. Always, I choose the dark music for listen.
And how we met? We met in 2009. Volkan wanted to record and produce music. And I had a label and studio then. I'm still in production business, and I helped him with the production. Then in time we became bandmates. We started playing together. I joined the stage, and from there onwards our lives got closer and closer, and this is how we started, and this is now we end up like this in this duo. Yes, Gag Tape has been how can I say? It started as a hobby because I like tapes. We're old school guys. Tapes are the way we learned music. This is how we discovered music in the back in the late 80s and 90s. And I just wanted to revive this feeling and this almost fetish for tapes. So this is why I started doing DIY tape label, producing at home actually, and very super limited editions of sometimes 25 copies, sometimes 50, sometimes 100. And only the music that I like, only the people that I like. But I had to give it a break because we were leaving Istanbul and moving to Athens. And during this process, I had to leave all my tape recorders back in Istanbul. And now I have to build the same systems in Athens. So there is a break now, but for sure I will come with new artists, new albums. Not too sure if I will reproduce the albums that I already produced. I don't want to repeat. I want to grow into other bands, other musics, and make a larger catalog. Sure. Well, in the last couple of years, everything is almost all shows are sold out. But we realized we feel this passion in many countries, but Mexico somehow stands out between them.
Yeah.
I don't want to compare any countries or any audience. Everybody is great. But there is something special about Mexico. I don't know how to say this part. Warmest and they just go crazy.
Patient.
Yes, almost too much. But tonight in Paris, we actually right after the show, we were like, this is just like the Mexican audience.
Yeah,
you know, there is as much passion and support and as much screaming in the place.
We really enjoyed it.
Yes, yes. Paris is great. Last time also was very good.
Mm-hmm.
We felt the excitement. And again, like sold out and as much passion as the last time. Thank you, Paris. What can I say?
We don't feel like this.
Yeah, we don't. We don't have a secret, or we don't feel like we stand out from the others. At least we shouldn't put it that way. We shouldn't put it that way. It's for other people to decide on this.
Yeah.
The audience. If they feel that way, thank you very much.
Yeah, nice.
But we don't, you know, set on the road for a success story or anything. We make music, and that's the whole story. It's a good thing if we can sell this out. But of course it's like a satisfaction that our music gets received by a good number of audience. This really makes us happy, of course. This I cannot deny this. But we cannot plan a success. If it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, well.
Yes, we are doing new recordings. But I think it's half of the next year we will do some things.
Well, we are not, we didn't plan a release date, but we are working on, we have new stuff coming, recorded at the moment. Hopefully next year sometime we will make a release.
When we feel it's finished.
Yeah, yeah. We will do.
Of course.
Yes. When you say cold wave, it sounds French to me almost. It's a French word.
Yeah, it's French, of course. It's come from France. Asylum Party, the best band for me from France. Little Nemo. Which name? These two bands I like more, but Opera Multisteel, no, I don't remember all, but these three bands maybe I can say now. Cold Dreams, amazing band too.
Je t'aime. Salut. yeah, like, no, actually, we don't know so much in French. I don't know why, that's strange. I thought about this actually. We didn't say so much, so many words in French tonight.
Yes.
Somehow, the French language is always far away. It's not. We know more Deutsch and Swedish
actually,
even.
Actually, I listen many French bands, and I forget to say Mylène Farmer. It's a pop star, but I am really fan of this woman. The first two, three albums. Taxi Girl. I like to listen French, but I can't speak.
French sounds. French sounds good though. It's a beautiful. It sounds aesthetic somehow. Oh,